I will just have one question. Do you have minutes of these meetings?
Yes, Your Honor.
Of the discussions in every meeting when you were drafting the memo, these rules and regulation, or when you were passing on the good conduct of prisoners, do you have minutes? Answer the question, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Because, can you bring all those minutes here, particularly on the matter of the NBD, four Chinese and all the others with heinous crimes? I would like, and the committee would like to see what sort of discussion occurred.
We will, Your Honor.
And by the way, who appointed all the people? Ikaw lang ang pipirma eh. Bureau of Correctional lang ang pipirma in the case of BJMP. Siya lang ang pipirma eh. Di ba dapat common sense, alam nyo na na ikaw ang ma-hot seat dyan. Dapat nag-iingat ka, di ba?
Yes, Your Honor. I rely on the expertise of those who have even participated in the
process. Why should you be, therefore, Director of Prisons when you have to rely on others? Why don't we just appoint the person you're relying on? Because when you are there, ikaw ang in charge.
Yes,
pagkaharap ka rito, ikaw ang in charge.
Yes, Your Honor. So the due diligence I've been doing is to ask them personally, ask them the implication of this law and to these people that are supposed to be. And then they could, in fact, the lawyer beside me says that if you release these PDLs with heinous crime through GCTA, there can never be a case filed against you because it's legal. But if you hold them, then there may be a case against you.
Okay.
They came to that point of convincing me that releasing them is the legal way of doing it, Your Honor.
Nakikinig ako sa'yo, pero with the permission of my colleagues, ito, bibilis ako na ito para mabilis na. Isa lang. 9 life imprisonment cases yan, dapat death, binabayan. Tinanggal natin ang death penalty. Hindi ka nagugulat na bibigyan mo ng good conduct yan?
Ako, sir, personally, hindi talaga dapat.
Ha?
Personally, sir, hindi dapat.
May hindi personal dapat. Pero views, yung mga bata sinasabi, alam mo. Ikaw ba'y pumirma doon sa kanilang order na i-release yan?
There is no order yet to release, Your Honor. There is a, as far as the ex-mayor is concerned, there is a memorandum of release recommended for his release.
By whom?
Recommended to me from through channel up to the Deputy Director General for Operations, and it reaches my office.
But the buck stops with you. Did you sign that order or not?
I did not sign the order to officially release Sanchez.
Bakit sinasabi ng mga bata, nung tinawag sila, pagdating doon, kinokongratulate na sila ng lahat ng mga tao doon sa Bureau of Prisons. At sinabi pa sa iyo, akala namin, Director, sir, pinayagan nyo na. In fact, naganda na yung mga bata, dadalhin sa Japanese restaurant yung kanilang tatay, dadalhin sa eye doctor.
There was never a completed release order of ex-Mayor Sanchez, sir. There was never an official release order.
Was he fingerprinted?
None, sir.
I was told that he was fingerprinted. Remember, you're under oath.
Yes, sir. I checked that. We checked that yesterday. If he was fingerprinted, he was not, sir. I signed a memorandum order that is the signal to process all the papers. But that is after I have continuously consulted with the lawyers. Why are we signing this? Now,
you
few minutes
consult
after
as
that,
long as you want, but
yes,
you signed the memorandum order to start the process. Is that correct?
I stopped the process, sir.
So, pumayag ka, start the process. Alam mo na nangingin ang permiso yan for executive clemency 6 months before. Alam mo na dinayan. Tama po ba yan?
I don't know of that
information. How can you not know? Bureau of Pardons and Parole yan. Di ba kayo nagkukonsultahan? Alam mo, dinayan. Ngayon, nag-a-apply siya sa iyo. Papayagan niyo, ipapaprocess mo. Di mo alam yun? Come on. You're a Marine. Captain.
Sir, the application of the law, sir, does not, that is their explanation to me, does not distinguish up to the time that the secretary says.
No, but there is such a thing as your own judgment.
Exactly, sir.
Especially, halimbawa, dito sa mga drug pushers na pinabalan, ikaw ba rin ang pumirma niyan? Siyempre, ikaw.
Exactly, sir. That's why I stopped the process of release of PDL Sanchez, because I believe he is not entitled.
You were appointed by the president, known for his battle against drugs, for his war against drugs. You were appointed as customs commissioner. Then you were appointed as undersecretary do sa civil defense mayon. And then you were appointed another opportunity for you to run the Bureau of Prisons. In spite of your record na hindi ka nag-a-abide, doon sa kudeta ka, tumakas ka, nung hinuhuli ka, yan ang record mo. Ang laki ng tiwala sa iyo ng Pangulong Duterte. Hindi ba tumalikod ka sa tiwala sa iyo ni President Duterte na papalayain mo itong mga drug pushers na ito? Papadala mo sa immigration? Ikaw ang pumirma? Kahit na sabihin mo pa nungungusulto ka, the buck stops with you.
Yes, Your Honor. I would appreciate if I would have a discretion to not follow the rules. But as we look at the data, sir, since 2004 up to 2016, there are already 105 drug pushers that were released through GCTA.
But that is your call, hindi ba? Lahat yan dumaan sa'yo. Halimbawa, kung may remorse itong si Mayor Sanchez, sabi nababasa ko, wala siyang remorse eh. In fact, sinasabi niya hanggang ngayon, hindi siya. Sinasabi niya yung si Kit Alquesa. Tinignan mo ba kung nagbayad na siya ng civil damages sa mga magulang, sa mga pamilya nitong napatay niya, at saka yung court cost, tinignan mo ba yun? Now, pag tinignan mo lahat siya, at sasabihin mo, hindi ko call yan eh, nasa batas yan eh. Then, tau-tauhan ka dyan. Di ba? Wala kang discretion, wala kang man lang sabihin na napakadelikado na situation na hindi lang para sa iyo, but sa susunod pa, Director ng Bureau of Prisons, kayo lang ang magdi-decide. Lalampasan nyo yung sinabi ng husgado, lalampasan nyo yung Bureau of Pardons and Parole, lalampasan nyo under the Constitution, Presidente lang ang pwede magbigay ng parole, magpatawad, pero ikaw ngayon, ang tanging tao lamang na magpapalaya, magpuputol ng sentensya. Dapat nag-iingat ka. Tama ba yun?
Yes, Your Honor. The discretion was removed by this manual, Your Honor.
That manual is man-made by a commission that you created or by the DILG and DOJ, correct? And by the way, Mr. Orseo, your undersecretary, wala sa batas yung sinasabi mo. Nasa manual yon. Ano? Saan?
Actually, Your Honor, in Section 97 of the Defense Penal Code, but which was amended by Section 3 of RA.
By the way, Senator Subiri is also here. Basahin mo.
Yes, I have these annexes here.
Manual yung binabasa mo. Nandun sa manual, pero wala sa batas yan.
It's in the annexes, Your Honor. It's part of the annexes.
Annexes?
Of this manual. The law is part of this annexes, Your Honor.
Saan? It only speaks of he shall be allowed a deduction of 30 days during the 11 successive years for each month of good behavior during detention.
Yes, sir.
But that doesn't mean that you're giving him 1 month lang yung kanyang titingnan. Ang layo nun. Ito for computing lang the deduction. Pero one month para sabihin mo pwede ka na?
Your Honor, when the committee decided on whether to give the full credit of, say, 30 days, we debated on whether to give that PDL a full credit for each violation or nothing at all.
And look at where we are now because you gave full credit. Look at where we are now. There is now ang laki-laking lamat ng batas ngayon sa atin. Kawawa yung mga taong pinatay, yung mga pamilya nila. Did you ever consider that for one moment?
Yes, Your Honor.
You did?
Yes.
And you were willing to sacrifice
nahihirapan na yung mga tao? Have any discretion to interpret the law otherwise because the law said 30 days per month.
Can you read the law first? Pareho naman tayo nag-aral, di ba?
Yes, Your Honor.
During the 11th and successive years of his imprisonment, he shall be allowed a deduction of 30 days for each month of good behavior during the detainment. Sinasabi lang yun, dinideduct mo 30 days of good behavior.
Yes, Your Honor.
Pero pag papalabasin mo, kailangan tignan mo yung buong taon.
Yes,
lahat ng kanyang pinasibyan.
Yes,
and by the way, can you put out the rules ang sinagay dyan sa manual? Rules nyo yan? Nakalagay dyan, hindi naka-uniforme. Pakita nyo yung litrato ni Sanchez na nakakulong, walang uniforme. Violation yan. Pakita nyo yun, nahuli siya may TV. Violation yan. Paano yan magiging good conduct? Preso Caballero ang tawag dyan. Di ba totoo, Mr. Secretary of Justice, public knowledge yan. Pag pumasok ka, Mr. Rafael doon, pag pumasok ka, may mga naka-cellphone doon. Ano ang bayad dyan sa mga cellphone na yan? Ilan beses na ako pumasok yan, nakikito. Paano may cellphone ang mga tao dito? Nakakapag-concert. Kuno nung lahat ang mga kubol nila. Ay ano? Tingin nyo, ilan ang pilo doon sa kama? Tatlo-tatlo. Apat? Apat ba? Apat. O, tingin nyo, mayroong aparador yan. Buksan mo yun sa aparador. Andun lahat ang damit. Wala akong nakikita ang uniforme na kulay tangerine. Ba't pinapayagan nyo yan? Tapos papayagan nyo ng good conduct? Yan ba yung good conduct na tinatawag nyo?
That is the reason we stop his release to review the granting of GCTA, sir.
You stop his release because sumabog na. Sumabog na sa tao, galit na galit ang tao. Re-detorialize ang mga dyaryo, tinira na kayo kaliwat kanan, which is very unfair because of the implementation of the law. That's where he got killed, right?